voice activity now. Go! So I can get right into it. Alright, starting off on Smash Bros. With these two. With Palu's recent nerfs, this is probably a matchup most solidly favorite in the idea of Pikachu. However, Pikachu has some trouble on Wi-Fi, I'll say. A lot of his combos are DI dependent, or they're true, it's just which way you need to follow is dependent on DI. So if it's harder to follow DI on Wi-Fi, then all of his combos are going to get cut short. And that isn't necessarily as big of a problem for Palu, who's going to be getting from guaranteed damage where it comes as soon as she did get a hit. That's right there is the problem. Yet, Palu just seems to be spacing pretty well on catching all of these jumps and he's quicker that game's almost the health card. Not letting him move around for free for the Thunder Catch of that air dodge. Alright. Getting back to the stick with the explosive flame. Trying to take on the center stage. 1, 2, 3 nairs is what it takes. It looks like he was going for some sort of roll or option to take center stage, but instead Mr. X goes for a straight up grab. Pretty even so far. Gotta grab off with that T-Dill, not letting its hit line scare him. Down towards him. Will he go down with the... Oh, okay. Of course, good aggressive quick attack coming through. Okay, no fear of that explosive land as he just manages to zip right past him. Pikachu will almost always manage to recover, but it's a matter of getting back on stage is not a problem. Is there another Pokemon? Outing should theoretically be taking her stocks a lot more earlier if they're about to get at those high percents, but Pikachu has his own unfairness that's in order to take stocks when he can. As every top tier has, I should mention. It's just a lot of Palu's damage moves are air-to-air based, and air-to-air or on tall characters air-to-ground, which is why she's super powerful against human-sized characters. But once you have little rats running around under her feet, it's gonna be hard to land anything. It's like, oh, secret runoff drag down there is gonna be combos into the downside. That downside was so early, I'm almost surprised. 130 is not super early, but it would have killed 30% earlier. Another Nair catching the jump. They're still not playing as grounded as he needs to. Not going as well. I'd like to see some more bears. He could do bears. Now he's down there. And missing the 2-frame and gets get up attack for it. Hydra's doing super well at playing aggressive off the jump. He's not letting Pikachu set up in center stage, instead always managing to counterpunch when he is. Yeah, there's Hydra. Oh, yeah, great follow. Pikachu actually getting super far going. Not having Hydra be actually on him with sort of thing. Going with these aggressive options that he is. Both his part are super aggressive. Another dash up because he's quick attacks back on stage. He doesn't really quickly attack too much. He keeps taking center stage and keeps getting dash attacks back on stage. Going to the platform at that time and managing to get away with the F-Hydro. F-Tilt's the long way. Great tech. Both his attacks on Wi-Fi notes. Pretty critical, I will say. A bit eager for this kill, sitting at 152. Instead, a quick change of pace by moving back with these T-Jolts and pressing forward with that dash attack will kill it. Giving Mr. L his first lead of the game, and his run is looking to extend as he keeps chasing Palutena across both sides. This is where, Palutena's up there. One of her more potent moves after with the nerf to her back air. And not being able to easily combo into her kills. This is what I like to see from Mr. L. Instead of always a quick back into the aggressive, now we're starting to use it just for movement's sake. Yeah, you have to be careful with the charge is going to be into picking that stuff. Going to ledge and covering the high with just a tower pillar of light. Tower pillar, those are the same word. Practically. Alright, game one going to Hydra, who, from what I understand, is the first seed of this tournament. So, Hydra showing his... showing what he needs to show, and the reason why he is seeded so high. Ready? Alright, no, not even a... not even a little bit of a change, just heading right back into the game. Battle is about to start, and no, I guess he's deciding to switch. If FD is open, he's gonna go there. Unless they're going right back to Smashville. Smashville's also a pretty good stage. But Alliance is the best. Yeah, that kind of makes sense in the flow chart. Like, oh, FD's not here. Smashville's not here. My last. I'm gonna just do that. Plus, with the tripod nature, it'll offer extension on both of these. The odd tripod layout in the longer stage will have to have a payment more often, because now you can take her her horizontal combos and extend them vertically more efficiently, instead of having to stick to center stage and finagle her way around there. Now there's platforms almost at every spot where it'll be opportune. So look for those combos, and importantly, look for those kills. Mr. L has been frequently going high with the attack. Prime opportunity for some up airs, some down airs, and some ups. Need to go up smash is gonna be a catch if that takes recovery high back on the stage. Some PGO will have no trouble with these slants, of course, but they might throw out some of these smash edge guard, or smash two frames. Hydra seems to be preferring open than going off stage, which really makes sense. It's hard to tell when you get too off stage. Back for the in center stage, that might kill. Most of the combo's not. Great use of his utility right there. As the skull bash two frame, but a great tech coming out from Hydra. I wonder what some of these chats are, whether they're just missing puts. Or if he's buffering an ape press and missing a jump. A cool empty hop will go drift from Mr. L as he ends up taking a dash attack on him and rests the jump out of shield, taking a stop of Pichu, and then it's two stops of beast going into the 5 minute mark. Highly competitive game. Which one is gonna be coming out of shield? As long as he sticks grounded like this and plays this slant like he can right now, then Palutena is gonna have some problems. But rushed quick attack in is gonna net him up quite a bit of damage. Net Hydra quite a bit of damage. On the spot to try and get back down, as he catches the challenge on the down air, but Palutena's up there much more disjointed. Right off the jump, another 37. After playing this super well. Backer comes through, but Hydra warps right past it. And chasing these up there for a good drift off stairs, trying to find a safe way to get down. But it's almost like Mr. L's looking for something to make a play, but Hydra knows that he's not rushing anything, he's making his area of effectiveness dangerous constantly. As Mr. L picks his options to be aggressive, Palutena doesn't have to worry about hitting Pikachu, because Pikachu will put himself in a place where it's more prone, leaving openings in his armor. But usual call stage with the out of shield coming a couple of smashes coming out from. Okay, here we go.
Melt high from the light.
flap the wings and hit the rat. An up smash catching the jump high as